हॅलो एवरीवन, आय एम मिस्टर यू एस पाटील, असिस्टंट प्रोफेसर, भारती विद्यापीठ कॉलेज ऑफ फार्मसी, कोल्हापूर. दिस इज अ व्हिडिओ लेक्चर ऑन इंट्रोडक्शन टू फार्माकोकायनेटिक मॉडेल्स. लर्निंग आउटकम्स. आफ्टर लर्निंग दिस व्हिडिओ, लर्नर विल बी एबल टू एक्सप्लेन कन्सेप्ट ऑफ फार्माकोकायनेटिक मॉडेल्स, आउटलाईन ॲप्लिकेशन्स ऑफ फार्माकोकायनेटिक मॉडेल्स, classify pharmacokinetic models, compare and identify one, two and multi-compartment models. Now first we'll see about what is pharmacokinetic model. After administration, a drug undergoes number of complex operations in the body. These processes include absorption, distribution, metabolism and excretion. These processes occur simultaneously, during which the drug is in a dynamic state and various complex processes are involved in handling of a drug in the body. If you take all these complex processes into consideration, then quantification of ADME becomes difficult, and therefore to simplify the complex processes such as movement of a drug between tissues and plasma and elimination, some assumptions are required to be made. And for this purpose, concept of pharmacokinetic model is used. Accordingly, the pharmacokinetic model is a mathematical model. It is a mathematical description of a biological system which can be used to simulate the rate processes describing movement of a drug in the body, that is absorption, distribution, metabolism and excretion. Applications of pharmacokinetic models. To develop equations to describe drug concentration. That is, we can use the pharmacokinetic models to derive equations to calculate the concentration of drug at different time points after administration of the dose. Second application, to obtain quantitative relationship between various pharmacokinetic parameters. Like, we can identify the relationship between the volume of distribution, clearance, elimination rate, half-life, excretion rate constant, absorption rate constant, etc. Next application is optimizing a dosage regimen for patient. We can use the pharmacokinetic models to design a dosage regimen, that is dose and dosing frequency, for individual patient or for general populations. We can use the pharmacokinetic models to study effect of altered physiological status on ADME, like it will be the effect of different disease conditions like liver disease or kidney disease on the ADME of the drug. We can use the pharmacokinetic models to evaluate the viability and bioequivalence for different drug products from different manufacturers. We can use the pharmacokinetic models for prediction of drug concentration after multiple dosing. That is, we can predict the drug concentration after multiple dosing by doing the single dose studies. Classification of pharmacokinetic models. Pharmacokinetic models. Three types of approaches are used for estimation of different pharmacokinetic parameters. It includes compartment models, physiological model and non-compartmental model. Non-compartmental models is a model independent method. The non-compartmental techniques are based on statistical movement theory, where different algebraic equations are used to calculate or to estimate different pharmacokinetic parameters. Physiological model is based on anatomic and physiologic data. It may be a blood flow related model or perfusion rate limited model. This model considers that blood flow is responsible for distribution of drug into various parts of the body. The drug is carried to the organs by arterial blood and leaves the organ by venous blood. According to physiological model, the concentration of drug in various tissues is affected by three factors: the size of the tissue, perfusion of the tissue, and ratio of concentration of drug between tissue and the blood, which is a measure of the affinity of the drug for the tissue. Compartment models. In this presentation, we are going to discuss concept of compartment model. Compartment model is further classified as closed model. an open model, and according to number of compartments, they are classified as one compartment, two compartment, and multi-compartment model. Multi-compartment models are further classified as catenary type of model and mammillary type of model. Let us now discuss concept of compartment model. Compartment model is a traditional and most commonly used model for pharmacokinetic characterization of drugs. Now, what is compartment? The term compartment describes group of tissues which have similarity with respect to certain characteristics, mainly blood flow rate to the tissue and partitioning. This means that the tissues with similar perfusion rate and similar permeability characteristics are grouped together in one compartment. This compartment is not a real physiological region or anatomical region of the body. The compartment is a hypothetical region where we consider that the tissues with similar blood flow and similar partitioning properties are grouped together. Compartments are connected to each other either by reversible pathway or irreversible pathway. For example, binding of drug to the plasma protein is reversible pathway, or transfer of drug or movement of drug between the compartments is a reversible pathway, whereas excretion of drug through the urine is an irreversible pathway. Assumptions of compartment models. First, the body is represented as a series of compartments arranged either in series or in parallel with each other. The rate of movement of drug between the compartment is described by first order process. That is, the distribution of drug follows the first order kinetics. The rate constant are used to represent rate of entry into and exit from the compartment. The number of rate constants required to describe the model that depends upon the number of compartments. An analysis of plasma concentration time data is used to find out the number of compartments. Properties of pharmacokinetic compartment. The compartment is considered to be a kinetically homogeneous. A compartment contains tissues that can be grouped according to similar kinetic properties to the drug, allowing for a rapid distribution between the tissues. When we say compartment is kinetically homogeneous, means all the tissues and body fluids in a compartment equilibrate with the drug in the plasma simultaneously, and once distribution equilibrium is reached, whatever the change in concentration is observed in the plasma, same extent of change will be observed in all other tissues and body fluids in that compartment. This is what said as a kinetic homogeneity. And though there is a kinetic homogeneity, this meaning is not like that all the tissues and body fluids in that compartment have the same concentration. Tissues within a compartment may have different concentrations of a drug depending on the partitioning and binding properties of the drug. Within each compartment, distribution is immediate and rapidly reversible. Compartments are interconnected by first order rate constants. That is, distribution between compartment is a first order process, but input rate constant may be zero order. That is, absorption may be a zero order process, or it may be a first order process. Types of compartment models. Compartment models are classified as an open model or closed model. A model is called as open model when administered drug is removed from the body by excretory mechanism. And if the drug is not removed from the body by excretory mechanism, then model is called as closed model. And thus, model is not open to removal of drug from the body, is a closed model. And hence, according to closed model, once the drug is administered, then it remains in the body forever. Open model is a unidirectional model. That is, input and output occurs in the same direction. But in reality, All the drugs or foreign substances which enters in the body are removed by the body by one or more excretory mechanisms. Hence, all pharmacokinetic models are essentially open models. Hence, we don't mention about the whether it is open or closed model, it is always assumed to be as an open pharmacokinetic model. When compartment model consists of three or more compartments, then there are two types of model arrangements, catenary type of model and mammillary model. Now, what is catenary model? This is a schematic representation of catenary model. As per catenary model, a series of compartments are joined to one another, just like compartments of a train. The compartment number 1 is a central compartment, which is connected to compartment 2, that is shallow tissue compartment, and second compartment is connected to compartment 3, that is a deep tissue compartment. Drug is equilibrated between compartment 1 and 2, and then equilibrium occurs between second compartment and third compartment. According to this model, there is no direct contact between central compartment and compartment number 3. And this is the drawback of this model, because in reality, all the tissues and body fluids in the body are connected to the circulatory system. What is mammillary model? Mammillary model considers that all the peripheral compartments, that is compartment number 2 and compartment number 3, are directly connected to the central compartment. This is what called as parallel arrangement of compartments. The drug enters in the body in the central compartment, which consists of blood and all highly perfused tissues. Compartment number 2 is a rapidly equilibrating or shallow tissue compartment and is connected to the central compartment. And compartment number 3 is a slowly equilibrating or deep tissue compartment, and it is also directly connected to the central compartment. All the organs of elimination, that is liver, kidney, are in the central compartment, hence drug output occurs from the central compartment. The rate constants, here K12 describes the movement of a drug between central compartment and second compartment, while K21 describes the rate of movement of drug between second to first compartment. Similarly, the rate constants for the transfer of drug between compartment 1 and 3 are K13 and K321. The rate constant K10 here indicates the elimination rate constant. What? How do one can identify whether given drug confers 1, 2 or multi-compartment model on body? Let us stop the video, think and write the answer in your notebook. If you have finished your work, then play the video again. The compartment model. For this, first we'll discuss what is one compartment model. The body may be considered as a one compartment model if the drug is instantaneously distributed between plasma and all body fluids and tissues. The equilibrium is achieved immediately, as if there is no barrier between plasma and other tissues. The plasma, body fluid and tissues are kinetically homogeneous. One compartment model. Here box represents the whole body. The amount of drug in the body is X. The elimination occurs from the same compartment. Elimination occurs by first order process, and elimination rate constant is the K. The input of the drug to the compartment may be by IV bolus route, or maybe IV infusion, or by any other extravascular route of administration. Based on the assumptions of first order elimination process, the rate of elimination will be equal to K into X. The drug and output of the drug are unidirectional. Compartment model before drug administration and one compartment model immediately after drug administration. This picture shows how all the body fluids and tissues equilibrate immediately with the blood, with the drug in the blood in case of one compartment model. One compartment model where all the organs are in the same compartment, drug input and output from the same compartment. This plasma concentration versus time profile plotted on a log scale shows that how the drug concentration falls in different tissues like kidney, plasma, muscle, and as here all these straight lines are parallel with each other, this meaning is that there is a kinetic homogeneity. Now, what is two compartment model? The two compartment model consists of two compartments, plasma, body fluids and highly perfused tissues in which drug is instantaneously distributed is considered as central compartment, whereas the tissues in which drug slowly distributed are considered as peripheral compartment. Accordingly, there are two compartments, central compartment and peripheral compartment. Actually, the rate of distribution in the body depends upon blood flow rate to the tissue and physiological properties of the tissue and the drug. In short, there are two parameters, perfusion rate and permeability, that decides the rate of distribution. Generally, less perfused tissues slowly attain the equilibrium and are in the peripheral compartment, and highly perfused tissues are in central compartment. But though this is a generalization, this is not always true because affinity of a drug for the tissue also causes difference in this respect. For example, brain is a highly perfused organ, but due to blood-brain barrier, non-polar drugs may attain the equilibrium immediately, whereas polar drugs may be slowly distributed, and thus brain may be in a central compartment for non-polar drug and will be in a peripheral compartment for polar drugs. The time required for attainment of distribution equilibrium with peripheral compartment is called as distributive phase. Thus, two compartment model has a distributive phase, whereas this distributive phase is not observed in case of one compartment model where drug is instantaneously distributed. In case of this two compartment model, during distributive phase, the concentration of drug in central compartment reduces due to two processes. One is the elimination of drug and second is the transfer of drug to the peripheral compartment. Therefore, fast decline in plasma concentration drug is observed during a distributive phase as compared to elimination phase. This is a schematic representation of two compartment model. Shows three pictures. The first picture is of two compartment model before drug administration. Second one, two compartment model immediately after administration, where we observe that some of the tissues and body fluids, mainly highly perfused tissues, are equilibrated initially with the drug in the plasma. Whereas, third picture shows two compartment model after distributive phase is completed. compartment model. It has two peripheral compartments, shallow tissue compartment and deep tissue compartment. Example of drugs which follows three compartment model: diazepam, digoxin and tubocurarin. This is schematic representation of three compartment model. Let us see how plasma concentration versus time profiles can be used to identify whether drug follows one compartment model, two compartment model or three compartment model. The first plot is of plasma concentration versus time on semi-log graph paper, where observe a straight line, a single straight line, which indicates that the drug follows the one compartment model, where the decline in concentration is only because of the elimination. The second plot shows that there is a breakpoint. There are two straight lines, the initial one with a greater slope, which indicates that there is a rapid fall in drug concentration, and which is due to the elimination and distribution, that the first section is a distributive phase, whereas after completion of the distribution, the decline is only because of the elimination. That is, if you observe a breakpoint on a plasma concentration versus time profile on semi-log graph paper, then it indicates that drug follows the two compartment model. And if you observe such a two breakpoints, then there are two distributive phases and the drug follows the three compartment model. Thank you.